Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Geetu. This is a follow-up on my last video on COVID-19. I'd received a lot of questions, so I thought I will answer them via this video. So without any further delay, let us go to our first question. This is from Durai Selvam. I recently heard that WHO has declared COVID-19 as a global pandemic. So how is it different from an epidemic? An epidemic means an outbreak that is occurring in a specific region, which is losing control. A pandemic is worldwide. It is affecting multiple countries and it is spreading easily. So in the case of COVID-19, it has spread to 100 plus countries and is losing control. So it is definitely turned into a pandemic. Do I need to be worried about traveling right now? Should I cancel my trip to the non-affected countries as well? It completely depends on where you're traveling to. We obviously need to be more safe than we usually are when we travel, meaning we need to be more vigilant about washing our hands, following proper hygiene, not touching our face, and if we are sick, definitely not going anywhere. We are seeing outbreaks occurring in Italy, Iran, Japan, South Korea, and now the US. So if I had a travel schedule to any one of these countries, or at least a nearby country, I would not go. I would try to push my plans. Will wearing a mask keep me safe? It is not just about wearing a mask, you also need to maintain proper hygiene, like washing your hands the appropriate way or using an alcohol-based hand sanitizer, which has at least about 60% of alcohol for it to be effective. Do not touch your face, nose, mouth, eyes, because this is how the virus spreads. Keep a safe distance from sick people, as there is no accurate information on how far the virus can spread from person to person. The more the distance you keep from people sneezing and coughing, the safer you will be. What kind of mask should I use to protect myself? There are basically two kinds of masks that can be used. One is a regular surgical mask and one is an N95 respirator. First, let us get this clear. Just usage of a mask will not keep corona at bay. Hand hygiene is the most important measure that should be followed. For common people and healthcare workers around patients, a routine surgical mask can be used. If you're handling an affected patient more closely, then an N95 respirator should be used. If you have no symptoms, then do not use a mask. One of the reasons to use a simple surgical mask is to avoid touching your face, because this is one of the most widespread ways to carry the infection. Just follow the basic precautions. Avoid overcrowded places, avoid touching your face, nose, and mouth. People having signs and symptoms suggestive of the virus, wear a mask and immediately seek medical attention. Also remember that the masks are carrying so many pathogens that disposing them off is as vital as using them. Is there a cure for COVID-19 ready? Currently, no cure is available. However, researchers are working actively to develop a vaccine against this disease. In terms of curing the disease, about 120 clinical trials are going on right now. They are testing different medications such as antivirals, antiretrovirals, even taking blood plasma from patients who have recovered and developed antibodies against this coronavirus and injecting it into other people. Trials are going on to see what works out. Is there a supplement or medication to boost my immunity against this virus? There's no such immune boosting supplement against this coronavirus. However, if you want to keep your immune system strong, then you should exercise, have a good sleep of 7 to 9 hours, you should eat healthy and follow proper hygiene. There is another question in the same lines. Can eating garlic help prevent infection with the new coronavirus? Garlic is a healthy food with good antimicrobial properties. However, there is no evidence from the current outbreak that eating garlic has prevented people from the coronavirus infection. Does a person become immune to coronavirus once he or she recovers from it? We have heard reports of people getting reinfected in China of COVID-19. What exactly happens when you get infected is there are two kinds of antibodies that come into action. One are the IgM antibodies that rise immediately you get infected, which are replaced by the IgG antibodies, which are popularly known as the memory antibodies. These IgGs determine how long your body offers protection against any reinfection. For each illness, the body has a different time frame on how long the IgG antibodies last. For example, in chickenpox, once we are infected, the body gives us a lifelong immunity against the disease. The same is the case with measles. After vaccination, the body provides us a lifelong immunity. Other illnesses like flu are not lifelong as the virus mutates each season. So far, we do not know how long the immunity lasts when we get infected by the coronavirus. but we should definitely have the immunity for a certain period when we are infected by the virus. How long can the virus remain contagious on surfaces? The truth is, we don't have exact data on how long these viruses survive on solid surfaces. What we have done is, we have looked at its cousins, the SARS, MERS and rhinovirus, and these viruses seem to survive only for hours. And the main spread of the viruses is through respiratory droplets and not surface spread. Though there is no official confirmation, the virus may remain on surfaces for under 6 hours. This may vary under various conditions, for example, the temperature and humidity of the environment and the type of surface. If you feel that a surface may be infected, then clean it with a common household disinfectant and protect yourself and others from the virus. Can products imported from China or parcels from affected countries infect you with COVID-19? Since viruses do not survive long on objects such as packages or letters, it is completely safe to use the products from China. According to WHO, the virus is contagious, but the spread mainly happens from person to person. Can the new coronavirus survive in hot and humid climate? Yes, COVID-19 has spread to countries with both hot and humid as well as cold and dry climates. Wherever you live, whatever the climate is, it is important to follow the precautions. Wash your hands frequently, cover your cough and sneezes with a tissue or a bent elbow. Discard the tissue in the bin and wash your hand immediately after this. Thanks a lot for all the support that I have received on my previous video. Please feel free to post any other questions that you have in the comment section below. So be safe, do not panic, take care and see you in the next one. If you have learned something from this video, then please like, share and subscribe to my channel.